It's almost a year now since suspected serial killer Joseph Burgess got into a gun battle with Sandoval County Sheriff Sergeant Joe Harris inside a cabin in the Jemez Mountains.
Both men were killed. Now there is another strange twist in this tragedy. Here's Kim Holland on special assignment.
Here it is, right here, okay. I think this is him.
A cop killer locked away in this back room, his remains in a box that nobody wants.
This is one of the higher profile.
Joseph Burgess's body sits at direct funeral services in Albuquerque. This is where he'll be for up to 2 years.
That's the state statute. They're hoping someone will come and claim the body within the 2 years.
But that probably won't happen. Investigators say for years, Joseph Burgess broke into cabins in the Jemez Mountains for food and other items. Burgess was a fugitive from a 1972 double murder in Canada. The FBI thinks he killed camper David Ely, who went missing in the Jemez Mountains in 2007. 2 years later, in July 2009, he snuck into a cabin where two Sandoval County deputies were waiting for him on a stakeout. Burgess shot Sergeant Joe Harris before Harris returned fire, killing Burgess. Harris died of his injuries.
The Office of the Medical Investigator held Burgess's body for a short time to see if anybody would claim it. And when no one came forward, OMI gave the body to this funeral home to be cremated on October 9th, 2009.
You're going to see his name and number.
And that's where Burgess has sat since. The cremation and storage cost $600. That fee is set by state law. And Sandoval County taxpayers got stuck with the bill. Ironically, one of those taxpayers is Tanya Harris, the deputy's widow. She tells me this, quote, continues to add insult to injury for me and my family throughout this horrific ordeal.
And there should be no reason why the taxpayers of Sandoval County should have to foot the bill for him.
Burgess's family members could reimburse county taxpayers if they reclaim his body. But the message was clear when Sandoval County Sheriff's deputies contacted them.
They didn't want anything to do with him. So they were told to come get him. They said, he can stay there. We're not going to come get him.
So Joseph Burgess sits here, locked away in this back room at the funeral home. Kim Holland, KRQE News 13.
After the 2 years are up, the funeral home staff will dispose of Burgess's ashes. They tell us most likely in some kind of nature area.